Take any digital circuit, you are very likely to find pull-up or pull-down resistors used in it. In this video, I will explain what is a pull-up resistor or a pull-down resistor, why it is used and how to choose its value. I'm Frank Donald from Gadgetronics. Let's get this started. So what is a pull-up or pull-down resistor? These are resistors that are used in digital circuits to pull the voltage level in digital inputs equivalent to the level of VCC or to the ground. Consider the OR gate shown here. Two resistors, R1 and R2, are used as pull-up resistor to pull the voltage in the input pins nearly to VCC. Similarly, pull-down resistors pull the voltage level down to ground or zero, and hence they connect from input pins to the ground. Next comes the most important question. Why use these resistors in our circuit? We all know that digital system is all about ones and zeros. These ones and zeros, either in input or output, is determined by its logic level. The logic level is nothing but the voltage range which decides how an input or output in a digital circuit is interpreted, either as a 1 or a 0. We will come to this in a minute. Not all digital devices are same. Each of them operates on a different logic level, depends upon which logic family the device belongs to. In fact, there are many types of logic families: TTL, CMOS, ECL, RTL, DTL. TTL and CMOS family devices are quite famous among these. Here is the logic level diagram of TTL device with a 5 volt VCC. As you can see from the diagram, the input voltage to TTL devices must be 2 volt to 5 volt in order for the device to interpret it as logic 1. Meanwhile, for logic 0, input voltage must be around 0 to 0.8 volts. And in between lies the pitfall. If the input voltage lies between 0.8 to 2 volts, then the input will go into undefined state and output will be unpredictable in nature. So, this is the region we want to avoid while designing our circuit. To summarize, input voltage 5 volt to 2 volt will give logic 1 and this is good. 0 to 0.8 voltage will give logic 0 and that's great. 0.9 to 1.9 volts will give undefined state and it should be definitely avoided. Now you might be probably wondering how exactly this undefined voltage get into our digital system. Let me tell you, we are surrounded by electromagnetic devices. The EM waves from these devices is capable of inducing voltage in the input pins of our digital systems. Consider this example using an OR gate. Here, when the switch is not pressed, the input pins are in floating state and EM waves from our surrounding can induce voltage. Let's say they induce 3 volt and 2.5 volt in the pins. This will push the entire circuit into undesired state. Now let's add a pull-up resistor to this setup. The resistor will pull the input pins close to plus 5 volt. This results in logic 1 in the inputs, which in turn gives logic 1 in the output as well. When the switch is pressed, the current flows through resistor to the ground, feeding 0 in both inputs, thus making our OR gate work as desired. The pull-down resistor works the same way. When switch is not pressed, input will be in logic 0 and output will be defined. However, when the switch is pressed, current flows to ground via pull-down resistor, thereby giving logic 1 to inputs, and output will go high as well. This is the reason why pull-up and pull-down resistors are used in digital circuits. In case if you are wondering why should we add the resistor in first place, why can't we connect the pins directly to plus VCC? let me tell you, it's a bad idea. Connecting the input pins to plus VCC will work, but when the switch is closed, it's gonna create a short circuit, and you don't want that to happen. The similar thing happens when you miss out the pull down resistors as well. Next, we are going to see how to calculate the value of these resistors. Every digital input pins consume current to operate and have some input impedance. Therefore, voltage drop occurs across these resistors. The choice of resistor should not be too high to restrict the current required for input pin to operate. It should not be too low as well, since it will allow excess current to flow and it will lead to short circuit. Let's assume that our input pin requires 100 microamps to operate and VCC is plus 5 volt. I am choosing a pull-up voltage of plus 4 volt to give enough room. Applying Ohm's law with all the available data will give me a resistor value of 40 kilo ohms. Substituting the 40 kilo ohms value in the circuit will give me an input voltage of about 4 volts. And moreover, it will pull the voltage level to logic 1. For the same case, I am choosing a pull down voltage of 0.5 volts. Applying Ohm's law will fetch me a resistor value of 5 kilo ohms. Substituting the 5 kilo ohms pull down resistor in the circuit will give me an input pin voltage of about 0.5 volts and the logic will be successfully pulled down to zero. So next time, check the data sheet of your chip for its specifications and choose your resistor correctly. That's all about pull up and pull down resistors. Hope you guys learned something from this video. Hit the like button if you did. Don't forget to subscribe. We publish new videos about electronic projects and tutorials once in every 10 days. Do share this video with others and spread the word. Thanks for watching. See you next time.